folks who are old enough, and I saw a news report the other day that featured a lady who had endured COVID-19, cancer, a number of different diseases, who was 107, who actually has a living memory of the influenza outbreak of 1918. But for most of us, we are living in a situation unlike anything we've ever had in our lifetime. Even for that lady who was 107, remember the Spanish influenza, what we are in many ways experiencing now is so totally different. So it is especially in this time that I thought it would be helpful as Pastor of Bethany to be able to share with folks in our congregation, as well as folks in our community and those who are able to receive these live streams and recordings, to be able to have some appreciation for this season of Advent that we are in. And so I thought I would take a little bit of time today, and Karen has joined me in videotaping this, so that we can share it with folks and let them be aware of some of the rich meaning of Advent. Never has the sense of hope and promise been something we have been more in need of as a society. And I want to suggest that that is exactly what Advent offers to us. Advent is not so much a 4 weeks of a preparation for the Christmas season. It is instead a season of penitence. It is a sense of remembering, first and foremost, that God promised through the prophets that he would send Messiah among the people. For generations, the hope and the promise endured among the people, until in the fullness of time, an announcement came to Mary, mother of Jesus, mother of God, as we are bold enough to proclaim her, Theotokos. An announcement came through the angel Gabriel in the sixth month of Elizabeth's pregnancy, that Mary herself, a young maiden girl, would bear the one who is the Son of God incarnate. Bear in her womb, just as we are all called as disciples in Christ, to be the Theotokos, to be the bearer of God in the world. And so in this holy season, promise and hope are brought to fulfillment as we anticipate with Israel in the promises and the hopes of the past, the coming of Messiah. But we also live in the presence that every day Christ, our Savior, is born, in us daily. And that is an important facet of many of our Christmas hymns that we will sing beginning on December the 24th. Of course, singing is something that has become dangerous for many of us, singing publicly. But we invite you, as we celebrate Christmas, as you hear the live stream or see the recording of our Christmas Eve service, join in singing in your own homes those wonderful Christmas hymns, the text of which speaks so much of Christ being born in us daily. But Advent also reminds us, inasmuch as we remember the past and the anticipation and the hope, it is also a season as it reminds us that God has sent his Son into our world, and thus the kingdom is here and now. There is also, and yet a third thing to the Advent season. It is the anticipation of our Lord's return in glory, just as he had promised, and yet no one can predict the hour or the moment. Jesus again and again says it will come like a thief at night. The apostles said the same thing, that the coming of the Son of Man will be coming like a thief at night. And at last, Maranatha, come, Lord. So these three things, the kingdom is now, and the kingdom is yet to come. The resurrection of the dead, the promise of eternal life that is brought to fulfillment and brought to sight. These three things, and anticipation in the past, the reality in the present of the present kingdom, and the anticipation and hope and promise of a future coming kingdom are all bound together in these 4 weeks. And so it's an important season for us to take a moment and pause before we begin the Christmas season. It's a very different concept than the sugar-coated Christmas season as it's often been celebrated among us. Behind me, you're on another level of chancel, is an Advent wreath circled, reminding us of course, the eternity of God. Also, the evergreen, reminding us of the sense of eternal life that is gifted to us and granted by God. I'm going to light the first candle on the Advent wreath, as we did a few weeks ago, and talk briefly about the specific meaning. In all 3 years of our readings or lectionary cycle, each year, A, B, and C, we have a gospel text that predominates. Year A is Matthew. Year B is primarily the Gospel of Mark. This year of 2020 begins the Advent season predominantly with the Gospel of Mark, year B. And next year, Advent 2021, will be year C. Advent, in fact, is the beginning of a new liturgical year. So in many ways, as I often say to the congregation, Happy New Year on the first Sunday of Advent. The first candle reminds us of our sense of expecting the miracle, expecting the time of this coming of the new year. So it is not an anticipation of Christmas. It is, in fact, a new liturgical year. We should be mindful that in the season of Advent, that it is a season that commemorates the preparations of Israel for the coming of Messiah. As I've said before, it is also the season that reminds us Christians that we live what Martin Luther called the now and the not yet. That is, the kingdom of God is now, having been ushered in at Christ's first coming. And yet it is to be as we await Christ's coming in glory and the resurrection of the dead and the final judgment. It sounds like a paradoxical statement, and it is the now and the not yet. There are numerous ways that families and you personally might fully more appreciate this season of Advent before the coming Christmas. Advent is a penitential season, as I reminded us, and yet the color of this season is blue, symbol of hope, color of Mary, who brought forth God's only Son in our world, and a reminder to us that we are to be the bearers of God, like Mary in the world. Theotokos. Advent is, of course, as I said, a penitential season. It is a time of expectancy, of proclamation, of preparation, and of joy. And so the first candle on our Advent wreath reminds us of the time of expecting. Consider daily in this season your baptism. When we were all brought into baptism through baptismal promises, I invite you to consider doing what for some is a routine. Make the sign of the cross. Luther reminded us to make the sign of the cross in remembrance of our baptism, that we are born each day, and that Christ is born in us today, each day. This question is asked of our baptismal candidates as we prepare to receive them. Do you intend to continue in the covenant God made with you in holy baptism? Or do you intend to live in the covenant of holy baptism, either for the affirmation rite or for the baptismal rite itself? To live among God's faithful people, to hear the word of God and share the Lord's Supper, to proclaim
Christ, God in Christ, the Word and Deed, to serve all people, following the example of Jesus, and strive for justice and peace in all the earth. Our calling to discipleship is always to live among God's faithful people. That can be a challenge in this world, and can be a challenge for us, especially in the midst of COVID-19, when we have to physically distance. And yet we are called to live at safe distance, and yet to be able to share and to continue to be the church, as we say in this congregation, continuously. You might consider in this season reading the Magnificat, that is from the first chapter of the Gospel according to St. Luke, verses 41 through 55. My soul magnifies the Lord, as Mary says, as we prepare daily to be the Christ, the God-bearer.
To be Gaudete,
rejoicing, and to be offered of ourselves, our time, and our resources. Our prayer during this Advent season, as we move slowly toward Christmas and Christmas Eve, which is still Advent on the 24th, is that we would be able to live out our calling as disciples. As we cling to Christ, and as Christ clings to us in faith, hope, and love. Hope is not realized in our present vision. The promises are not realized in our present vision. Instead, they come because of the advent of our God. God, who has come into our midst, who goes with us. That's what the word Advent means. It is the coming. May you be blessed in this holy season.